Hello, everybody. My name is Graham Elwood, and you are watching the Political Vigilante. So we've talked about at the live streams. I do a live stream every Sunday at 3 p.m. Pacific. That the wildfires in Australia keep getting worse. Ron Placone and I were there on tour in November, and they had already been on for like a month or so at that point. And it's now January, and they're worse. And they have a conservative prime minister who has said stupid crap like, "Well, let's not politicize it. Now's not." I hate it. I hate it. Only corporate sellouts. So, well, let's not politicize. What are we supposed to? What? We can't politicize a whole country's on fire. We just had bad wildfires again in California, and PG&E was being held liable, as well they should. And any politicians that let that happen or took money from them, this is why we need regulation. So Scott Morrison said, "Oh, let's not politicize it." And this was the reaction when he went to this small town where people have been like, it's nuts. I'm going to show you a map in a second how big it is, the fires in Australia. But this was the reaction by some Australian citizens when they saw their prime minister.
How are you? How are you?
I'm only shaking your hand if you give more funding to our RFS. So many people here have lost their homes.
We need some money.
Yeah, and then she says, "Bless her," and then this guy comes in to try to quiet her down. Oh, shh. What? Oh, it's some good old Aussie mansplaining.
We need more help.
Look at this idiot. Firefighter wouldn't shake his hand. That was a firefighter that wouldn't shake his hand. This is a small area in New South Wales, right?
For a cup.
We have hearts of gold, Mr. Prime Minister.
No, you're an idiot, mate. You really are.
You won't be getting any votes down here, buddy. You're an idiot. Who votes Liberal around here? Nobody. No Liberal votes. You're out, son. You are out. Good night, Lena.
See you, mate.
Bye.
What about the people who are dead now, Mr. Prime Minister? What about the people who have nowhere to live?
You're not welcome, you...
Every single time this area has a flood or a fire, we get nothing. If we were Sydney, if we were North Coast, we would be flooded with donations, with urgent emergency relief.
You saw that one guy called him a cunt. Like, and just so you know, this was explained to me, Liberal there, the Liberal Party is the Conservative Party. So it means a little something different there. So when you say you'll get no Liberal votes down here, that's what he's saying. Oh, let's not politicize it. What do we, don't politicize climate change? Half your country's on fire, jackass. That's, people need to speak up like that. RFS is the, I think that's their fire service. And this is as of January 6th. As 4 a.m., there's 130 fires still burning across New South Wales. That's just one state. Even with current conditions, including the rain, which was good, they got rain yesterday, there are around 2,000 firefighters out working hard to protect properties and contain these fires in the morning. Look at that. I'm going to show you another statistic. All the major wildfires, the ones in Siberia earlier this year, the Amazon ones, which were awful, the Amazon rainforest are the lungs of the earth. The 2018 California wildfires, which were the worst, that broke a record, dwarfs them. I live here. I was there for this. This was awful. This was awful. I saw fires in the hills here in Malibu, several miles from my house. It's nothing compared to this. Nothing. And what, Liz Warren wants to green up the military? Joe Biden says we need a middle ground. What's Mayor Pete's strategy going to be? Him and Klobuchar are just going to try to out-centrist, incrementally bore people the fires to death? That'll suppress fires and that'll stop climate change? They're so boring with their incremental centrism? Klobuchar Buttigieg, Snowerfest 2020. Many forests will take decades to recover and the fires are worsening Australia's extinction crisis. All these species, koalas, all the species are going, they're dying. To put it in perspective for Americans, this map, this is Australia, exact size, it's a massive country, laid out, this is per scale. This is from ABC News. This is over the continental United States. So this is New South Wales in this area, and I'm not where, but it's not just this, they just show you this, this is the whole country, man. So look, if this was happening in America, part of Oklahoma, little parts of Texas, parts of Arkansas, all of Louisiana, almost all of Mississippi, Alabama, Georgia, South Carolina, North Carolina, most of Virginia, all of West Virginia, most of Ohio, Pennsylvania, part of Michigan, a little bit of Wisconsin, Minnesota, both of the Dakotas, Kansas, Colorado, part of New Mexico, most of Southern California, gone, Oregon, Idaho, Montana, all this part of Canada. Look at this. That's a third of Canada. Let's not politicize it. Okay. So should we? Because that's my question when I'm watching what's happening in Australia. What happens if Los Angeles has to be evacuated? What happens if San Francisco? Well, like that woman said, if this was Sydney, everybody'd be doing something about it. So, okay, they'd protect the major cities, San Diego, LA, San Francisco, Sacramento. But if you live in one of these small towns here, you're sorry. Look at that. And let me tell you something. The majority of Australia's population lives along the coasts. So these areas that aren't getting really, there's very few people here. The majority of the country lives right here. And Perth is over there. But this is Adelaide. This is Melbourne, Sydney, Canberra, I believe. All that. All the way up to Brisbane, the Gold Coast, this is all that. There's video footage, just horrifying video footage of people in like beach towns standing in the water, and the ocean is, they're like standing in the ocean and the fires are right there. They got nowhere else to go. So yeah, politicians that say, oh, let's not politicize climate change. Politicians that take money from the oil lobby. Politicians that don't have a real Green New Deal. Yell at them. Yell at them. Ask them those questions. That woman with her dog. She wasn't threatening him. She wasn't saying, I'm going to kill you. She wasn't threatening. She just said, oh, how come you're not helping us? How come you're not helping us? What are you going to do? That one guy said, you're an idiot, mate. The other guy said, we're not voting for you. Yeah. Gavin Newsom, governor of California. Are you going to do anything about what PG&E did? Or do you take money from them? And this breaks my heart. We were just in Australia. I know we have so many Australian fans. Ron and I went to the other part of the globe and we were so supported and just like all these progressives in another country. And this is what they're having to deal with. And it's gotten worse since Ron and I were there. They're in the middle of their summer. I mean, they got a little rain in parts of it, but this is nuts. A whole continent is going to go up in smoke? Years and years of drought, which is caused by climate change. And if you're going to tell me, oh, climate change, I don't want to hear it. This is what happens when we let the corporations and the oil lobby buy politicians and do everything. Because let me spell something out very simply to any of the, like, oh, it's a geoengineering conspiracy or whatever. It's real simple. You follow the money. If the whole world goes, we got to get off of fossil fuels, the fossil fuel industry loses trillions of dollars. So they're spending money to fund disinformation campaigns, to do climate change denial, to have that stupid granny petrol. But Greta, drink oil for breakfast, right? All that fake ass friends of science accounts like that, the American Petroleum Institute, right? Australia has a lot of mining. They have a lot of mining. So they buy politicians so that the same thing. What's it going to take? All of the western part of the United States and the South during a really heavy several years of drought just up in smoke? This is awful for Australia. But they don't have as much of a population as we do. They have about, I don't know, something like 23, 25 million people in this whole country. It's awful. What's happening is awful. I'm just trying to put it in perspective. I'm not minimizing what's happening in Australia at all. It's awful. I'm trying to put it in perspective for Americans. You know what we have here on the East Coast? This area, this is hundreds of millions of people. These are a bunch of big cities in here. Detroit, Cleveland. I mean, like, look at this, dude. Charlotte, Raleigh, Durham, Atlanta, Pensacola, Florida, New Orleans, Lafayette, all of this. Cities Ron and I have gone to on tour. Phoenix, Tucson, San Diego, Los Angeles, San Francisco. If this happens here, this is like hundreds of millions of people affected. And if you think it can't happen here, it already has. It already keeps happening. So I appreciate all the Australian fans that have sent me all this information and said, Graham, please talk about this. My heart goes out to you. We're just down there. I've been to Australia numerous times. I have friends. Many of you are friends. I was on Will Anderson's podcast, Alice Fraser, who does Tea with Alice. These people are good friends of mine. And this is awful. But this is happening all over the world. I mean, look at this. Australia, Siberian, Amazon, all 2019. And the Australian ones are keeping going into 2020. This was just a year ago, the California ones. And 2018 was worse than 2017, which was worse than 2016 in California. This is four continents. Australia, Asia, South America, North America. We got to wake up, folks. That's why I'm for Bernie Sanders as a Green New Deal. I won't accept anything else. It's the one thing I'll give Tom Steyer credit for. He's a billionaire, so they just spend his money to save the planet rather than run a stupid presidential race. He does say he will declare a state of emergency the first day he's president. He's never going to be president, but that's a fine plan, and that's what Bernie Sanders needs to do. Tulsi Gabbard signed the OFF Act. Let's be real clear, folks. If we don't fix climate change, everything else, I don't care. I don't care what else you do. It's done. But we're going to bomb Iran and create more refugees? Oh, great. That'll help. That'll help reverse climate change. Get these insane psychopaths out. And don't think that the dumbass Democratic Party is going to save you. Vote them out. Anybody that voted for Scott Morrison, let them know they made a massive mistake. Inaction is helping make this worse. Years and decades of not addressing climate change is what's making this worse in Australia, in America, everywhere. If you still don't think climate change is real, then, you know, when your house goes up in smoke, you'll, like, what do you, I don't know, who you're going to blame, Russia or immigrants, or I don't know what, you know, maybe you should go because you have no more, you never had logic in your brain. I don't know what it is. Thanks for supporting the show. ExxonMobil doesn't support me. I cannot do this show without your help. I do this, you guys fund this show, you support what I do, like, share, and subscribe. YouTube unsubscribes people, even though we've crossed 58,000. It's great. My goal for 2020 is to get to 100,000 subscribers, so I need your help with that. Share these videos, thumbs up, positive comments, all that stuff's great. Share it on your social media. Go to patreon.com/Graham Elwood, go to rockfin.com/Graham Elwood, and then visit Ron and I on the road when we do the Progressive Comedy Tour. January 25th, we're doing Valencia, California. February 8th, we're doing Tucson. February 29th, we're in San Francisco. March 12th, we're in Orlando. March 13th, we're in Miami. We're going to be adding Tampa on the 13th. April, we are in Seattle and Portland. More cities added every day. Go to GrahamElwood.com for all your tour dates and follow me on social media, at Graham Elwood on Twitter. That's where I talk politics. Thanks for coming here, folks. Thanks for getting your news. And you're all making Gotham great again.